Hi, I'm Brian Cornes, Aerospace Market Director at MTS. AeroPro software provides a tightly integrated control and data acquisition interface with unmatched control loop optimization tools to accelerate even the most complex high-channel tests. MTS is constantly improving AeroPro with new features that make software easier to use, improve test article safety, provide new and better data visibility and integration, and improve test times that yield faster test results. In this ongoing series, we'll demonstrate some of these key AeroPro features. In today's session, we are joined by Michael Dembinski, one of MTS's many system integration engineers. Mike is going to demonstrate a new AeroPro feature called Model Display that allows you to monitor test data on a 3D model during the test. Sensor points on the model are color-coded, making it easy to identify test article strain. Take it away, Mike.
Hi there, I'm Michael Dembinski, and today we're going to be looking at the model display portion of the data display application. I have AeroPro opened up here and I have a test configured. Within this test configuration, I have a number of data acquisition channels added into here. For me, these data acquisition channels are all virtual channels, and I have a sine wave running on each of them. Each of the sine waves are phased slightly different from each other. For you, what you would have is you would have actual data acquisition channels, meaning actual strain gauges or actual transducers. I'm using virtual channels just so that I have something to bring into the data display application for us to look at. If we open up the model display, I have something set up in here already. As you can see the 3D model of our aircraft. This would be our test article. And then we can see individual colored dots scattered along here. These individual scattered dots would be the strain gauges or transducers, and the color of these dots is dependent on the value of your signal. You can choose to gradiate between any colors that you want. For me, I'm gradiating between green and red. If I look in the tables display, we can also see that there are XYZ coordinate values associated with each of these data acquisition channels. You're able to manually edit each of these if you like. But maybe a little bit easier is to go into the properties section and just import a signal list with all your XYZ values already populated. We have the capability to have any normal manipulation of the 3D model that you're used to, such as panning, zooming, and rotation that you're already familiar with in 3D modeling softwares. We also have some other abilities, such as going into the graph section and making it a solid model, or changing it to a perspective view. If we wanted to look at what the value of any of these individual channels are, we're able to zoom in on a section, and we can click and hold on a particular point, and this will give us a live readout of what the data acquisition channel is actually reading at any given moment, as well as some other channel information, such as the name. If we wanted to see a graph of this, we can simply double-click on the point and we can pull open an individual plot for that signal, and we can see that sine wave that I was talking about earlier. If we exit out of this portion, it'll bring back up our normal view that we were looking at, and we can go about what we were doing. In order to bring in a model, this model has to be a .obj file, and if we look over here, we can see I have the same model open here. And if we go into the properties section in the model tab, we can simply change the model by clicking on the three dots here and then choosing from any other model that we have. And we can see this other model. And then we can have our pan, zoom, and rotate back and import our signal list on top of this. And that's our model display within our data display application. Thanks for tuning in.
Thanks for watching. Please check out our other videos and MTS webpage for more information. If you are interested in leveraging these features, please reach out to your local rep about an AeroPro upgrade or training. MTS is committed to improving the AeroPro user experience and welcomes your feedback. Please contact us if you have ideas for new features. Thanks, and see you next time.